Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff, and in today's video, we are talking all about the new larger print than cut in Cricut Design Space. This is a feature that people have been asking about for years, so I'm super excited to be able to share this with you today. So I have this image here on my desktop. It's a cactus. If you'd like this free cut file, you can go ahead and grab it in the description below or in the blog post for this video, which is also in the description. We're going to be using this cactus because it sort of has the right shape to show the maximum sizes that we can use with this new print then cut. If you're not familiar with Cricut Print Then Cut, it's basically a feature for the Cricut Maker and Cricut Explore machines that allows you to print out an image on your home printer, and then your Cricut will use its sensors to cut around the edges of your project. You can use it to make all sorts of projects like labels, stickers, magnets, even sublimation projects. So to start, you may be viewing this video right when it first comes out, which means that you're going to need to use the beta version of Cricut Design Space. Good thing, that is available to everybody. So if you go up here to the hamburger menu and you go down to settings, right here in application experience, you can turn on the beta version. My caveat is that you have to save anything you're working on because this will just immediately restart Cricut Design Space and you'll lose any work you are working on. So once you are sure you're in beta, you will have access to this new larger print then cut. With this new release, the way that Cricut uses registration marks has changed. Before, they got in the way of the size of the image, but now they've changed things a bit so that the registration marks are only in the way a little bit. There's more room at the top and bottom between the registration marks for your image, allowing images to be a bit bigger. So you can go ahead and see this here. If I click Make It, you'll see here that I have my image in my prepare screen. And if I hover over, you'll see this red registration mark outline here. It sort of is what I'm going to call a tolerance. That's sort of a graphic design word, but a tolerance is basically how close you can get to something before it doesn't work anymore. So before, the tolerances would not let you get nearly this close to these registration marks. But you can see here now that you can actually go up in between. You can go all the way over here onto the side, which means that you can create a much bigger image. So let's go ahead and make this the maximum width it used to be, which is 6.75. Now if I go to make it, so you'll see that there's actually quite a bit more room where this cactus can live, right? You can actually push it all the way up to the corner because the actual image doesn't cover those registration marks. So when I click away, our actual image is not in the registration marks, which means that this will have no problem cutting. That also means we have so much more room here over on the bottom and the right to work with. So you can make this image quite a bit bigger. Finding the size that your image can be in Cricut Design Space, though, can be a little bit confusing with this new program. So one of the things they've done is they've added an auto resize feature, which is great. So let's say we've got this image, but we want to make it just as big as we can on the paper. The way to do this is a little tricky, but you can do it here by just making your image too big. And once it's too big, you can go over here and click the little exclamation warning, and it will say your image is too large. Auto resize the image to fit in the space. So the size that this can be is going to change depending on whether or not you have artwork in the corner of your image. If you have artwork in the corner of the image, it's going to run into those tolerances where the registration marks are. But for here, you can just auto resize it. And this is the maximum size that this particular image will fit when you go to make it. So you can see here, it's now using all of this space, which is awesome. This is a much bigger image than you could have printed before. So that's just 8.5 by 11, but there are now 5 paper sizes that you can use, and there are a couple different ways to access them. So the first is to go to that hamburger menu, click settings, and then go up here to the load type tab. And here you can choose your print then cut page size. So we have A4, letter, legal, tabloid, and A3. In the US, this tabloid is a huge piece of paper. So obviously you're going to need a printer that can print that big, but if you have it, you can now do print then cut in these enormous sizes. The other way to access those sizes is to, again, make your image too big, and then you can go here to the warning symbol, and you can change your page size, and it will open that up again. So let's say I wanted to make it tabloid sized, I can do it from there. Now, if you want to auto resize it and you don't see that little warning, again, you have to make it bigger. I wish there was just a way to do this where you don't have to actually make your image bigger. Just make your image too big, then go here, auto resize image, it will resize it. And then when you go to make it here on your preview screen, you can see that it will fit exactly where it needs to go. Again, I can bump this up here because it's not running into those tolerances, the artwork itself. The image isn't quite as tall as it could be on this tabloid piece of paper. This is an enormous upgrade for print then cut. So let's talk about the print then cut print area for these different paper sizes. Cricut hasn't published any sort of print then cut size because it really depends on your image. If you have an image that has, you know, image pieces in the corners, it's going to have to be a little bit smaller. But if you have an image like this cactus, it can be a much bigger because it doesn't have any artwork in the corners. So here's what we've got. As far as I've done some testing, these are the maximum measurements if you don't have artwork in the corners. So for A4, 7.9 inches by 10.06 inches. Letter is 7.44 inches by 9.94 inches. Legal, 7.44 inches by 12.93 inches. Tabloid, 9.94 inches by 15.94 inches. A3, 10.63 inches by 15.49 inches. I know this is not particularly precise. The last numbers were a lot more easy to remember than these, but again, it really does depend on the image and whether or not you have artwork in the corners. Finally, if you're a sublimation crafter, you might be wondering if this is now big enough to do things like tumbler wraps. They take up almost an entire sheet of paper. Yes and no. So if you have an 8.5 by 11 printer, you're still not going to be able to do it. It still is not big enough. Those registration marks get in the way. And even if those registration marks weren't there, you still can't print that wide. If you have a larger printer, however, like something that can print tabloid size, you can fit a tumbler wrap on one of those. You just need the bigger printer, which I know many people don't have, but if you do, it's an option. And that's it. That's basically an overview of the new print then cut. Pretty awesome, right? I am so stoked about this upgrade because I have been wanting much larger print then cut for a long time. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you found this tutorial helpful for this new larger print then cut. If you have any questions, of course, leave those in the comments. If you want this cute free cactus file, go ahead and click that link in the description, and I'll see you next week.